bringing you the good stories of Mississippi's people, places, and things to do. Now, here's Rebecca.
Good afternoon, SuperTalk Mississippi. You are tuned into your radio happy hour. That's the good things. I'm your host, Rebecca Turner. We've got Rhino in studio with us today. And after the week we had last week, you know you want to go ahead and plan an adventure in Mississippi. So head on over to visitmississippi.org. You probably want to plan one nowhere near your zip code, area code, people you live with. It's probably not a staycation, but a true vacation and a getaway. And you can get away too to supertalk.fm/watch. You'll see that I am not alone today in the Good Things studio. I'm happy to have my friend, Jill Gordon. She is the CEO and founder of Enrich Mississippi, but she's also a mom who had to pull working from home, homeschool, and snow, ice, all the things last week, too. So,
yes.
And it's your birthday.
Yes.
So happy birthday.
Thank you.
So how was it? Did you survive? I feel like I haven't had a week with makeup or hair done.
I wore makeup every day, but if you know me, you know that's not uncommon. No, I mean, I get up and get dressed first thing in the morning and started working, and I had to get on my son a little bit to stay engaged with virtual learning. I'm sure most parents do. Mine is a very hyperactive child, so it was quite interesting. We skied in the neighborhood. We snowboarded in the neighborhood. I mean, he'd do school and then we'd play, so I think that was a good mix.
Yeah, and I think by now, I feel like we're starting to get a little bit of these survival skills we didn't know that we had as parents. With the first shutdown, which is looming on almost a year ago, it's like they left for spring break and then the school never took them back. So we were feeling a little bit like, oh no, is this how this is supposed to happen all over again? But no, they're all back in school today, I assume statewide. I know at least here centrally, they're all back and going because it's safe and the roads are opened. But you realize, hey man, as a mom, or a parent or a grandparents or whomever had to watch the kids for the week, you realize I am tougher than I thought I was, and we can do this. Like we can survive these weeks together, although we don't necessarily want to see many of them coming along. But I know you talk about your son, Jill, being hyperactive and just a big centerpiece of your world. He's a big centerpiece of why you sort of left your full-time job way back when and started Enrich Mississippi. So for those that are hearing that term for the first time today, explain to us how that got started.
Okay, well, I'm glad that you brought that up because we had our one-year anniversary in December of this last year, and it's really been a dream come true for me. I mean, I had this vision, and I planned and executed, and I had lots of great volunteers that helped me. But Enrich was started because I kept seeing alerts in the media and alerts in the news about vaping-related deaths, vaping-related incidents, vaping. It was everywhere that I turned. I was at a high school football game. It could have been middle school. I don't know. I just went to support Northwest. And I was on the bleachers with my friend CJ, and we were talking, and I said, this vaping problem has become such a big deal. And we just started looking around, and tons of teenagers were just openly vaping in this, stadium. And it bothered me. Like, they just had they weren't even hiding it. And so I, at that point, decided, and I told her, I remember where I was sitting and the conversation we had, and I said, I've got to do something about this. And so I did. I left my job with the State Medical Association that I loved. I loved working as their marketing director. But I left in September, started studying for real estate, and also started forming the nonprofit. There's lots, obviously, involved in doing that. We really launched effective January, and we were thankful to the State Department of Health because we got our first grant. We held that summit. Remember we did the SuperTalk then? Did that summit in February. It went so well. We were going to do another one, but then COVID, right? And so we kind of had to rethink our strategy. During COVID, we really focused on building this youth leadership team. And
why is it important to you for Enrich Mississippi to have the leadership team by the peers that you're trying to reach?
Very good question. Peer-to-peer prevention nationally is highly, highly effective. And, it's one thing for a middle-aged woman to stand up in front of a classroom or stand up in front of teenagers and have the conversations of what they shouldn't do and why. And it's another one to have a peer in their social setting say, you know what, that's not a good choice. You know, I'm and learn how to say no. We talk a lot about peer pressure, and we talk a lot about their social settings and how to talk to other teens, but primarily peer-to-peer prevention is my main strategy because it is so effective and has been proven nationally to work.
And I would think, though, the first sort of hurdle would be to even get the teens to open up to the fact that maybe it's not a good alternative to cigarettes, or it's not, you know, there's still some health concerns. Because I think when vaping first hit, for everybody, adults and anyone, well, obviously if you're under the age of being able to legally buy cigarettes, I assume that would not be necessarily a good thing, but all 18 above, everyone thought, hey, this is a opportunity to, you know, smoke less or take in less tobacco, which, you know, after, you know, hindsight's always 20/20, and now we're learning more about the substances that go into the vapes and the dangers mm-hmm. that come. Was it harder to crack that? Because I felt like we had a good hold on kids at least learning the dangers of tobacco, but now it's like, you're going to take this from me too? So how did you sort of crack that with them? Or yeah. are you cracking it? Because yeah. it's still an ongoing conversation.
It is an ongoing conversation. There's a lot of work to be done in the prevention of e-cigarette use in teens. I say this a lot during the summit. We recently spent the last 7 months recording and producing the state's virtual vaping summit funded by the Department of Health and hosted by me. And the youth leadership team was a huge part of that. But it's something that deserves our attention because since 2010, vaping's more than doubled in teens in Mississippi. That's huge. Like, when was the last time that you saw something from 2010 to now increase 1,700% in high school students?
Why do you think that is?
Because it's easy. It's electronic, so it's geared for their generation, and it's easy to conceal and it's easy to hide.
Yeah, because you don't have to wear gloves to hide your e-cigarette.
That, yes. And now, you know, when it first came out, I remember seeing the first vapor, like, and I was like, oh my gosh, the amount of smoke that came out was just unbelievable to me. Now they can vape and no smoke comes out at all. So, I mean, you can't really tell if they are. So it's incredibly easy to hide. The youth leadership team in the summit, we have several pieces of information really for everybody included, and it is available on demand. So I want to make sure the community knows of that resource. But the youth leadership team talks about that very thing, how they've been marketed to, why they think that their peers think it's so cool. Social media plays a huge role in that. You know, the word and news can travel so much faster now. Well, if you spend any time on TikTok, which I find highly entertaining, but if you spend any time on TikTok, you'll notice all those young people have vapes in their hand in their TikToks. And it's just a common thing of their generation.
What is it that's so dangerous about vapes that you want parents to at least be informed about, then also to share with their kids?
Well, prolonged use of anything that you're inhaling obviously has medical complications and implications. We spend a lot of time on the summit talking about that. Like, what is in the vape? It is aerosol, chemicals, can be drugs. There have been drugs found in these vapes in our schools. And so we did a panel discussion with Northwest Rankin and Rankin County School District, and they talk about the different types of substances that they were seeing in those vapes. Callie, one of our youth leadership team members, she's from South Mississippi. She's a high school student. She has a story of a young lady that was found unresponsive in their school.
Well, Callie's joining us here on Good Things. Hey, Callie.
Hey.
Have you unthawed?
Ma'am, it's kind of hard to hear.
That's fine. You have any ice? Did you get to enjoy your time at home?
Yes, ma'am. We didn't have any ice, so we didn't have any extra days off, but we are close enough to the New Orleans area that we did get Monday and Tuesday off for Mardi Gras, even though that there was no, like, parades or anything, but those 2 days were good.
Well, that sounds like you did have a good, at least, time off. Jill was sharing that maybe you have a personal story with vaping that encouraged you to be part of Enrich Mississippi's leadership program. Can you share that?
Yes, ma'am. Miss Jill, well, first off, a college student kind of got in touch with her somehow. I'm not really sure. And then my cheer coach saw that Miss Jill was looking for people to be a part of this team. And she kind of reached out to me and wondered if I would want to be a part of it. And I was like, well, yeah, of course, you know, I will. And then once honestly, I didn't really think it was going to be that big of a deal. Well, once I really got into it and I started learning all these things that I was completely, like, I didn't know anything about. I didn't know how dangerous it was. I didn't know that vaping could cause way more damage than cigarettes. I was completely clueless, and I've learned so much more. And so it made me grow a big heart for people who choose to do that daily.
Well, Kaylee, we're going to hold on, and we're going to get back to you and your story with Enrich Mississippi coming up next here on Good Things.
Farm Bureau Insurance is excited to introduce Drive Down, our new deductible rewards program. Drive Down lets customers save on their deductibles as a reward for driving safely and can help them become safer drivers in the process. Getting started is simple. Download the free mobile agent app and enroll in Drive Down. As a reward for signing up, you'll save an immediate 5% off your deductible after your first trip. Enroll in Drive Down today with Drive Down and Farm Bureau Insurance. Safe driving saves.
SuperTalk Mississippi.
From outer space, visitors from another world.
We've had contact with
bug-eyed monsters.
This is actually a flying saucer.
Flying saucer?
I'm from another planet.
Where late nights are kind of weird.
Well, they must have a reason for their visits.
The unexplained, the weird, and the downright creepy. Coast to Coast AM with George Norrie. Late nights.
SuperTalk Mississippi.
SuperTalk Mississippi,
your new home for the Ben Shapiro Show.
We don't hold back. We never shy away from telling you the truth.
The most electrifying national talk show on air today.
We have the most important guests and the biggest thinkers in America.
Ben Shapiro, brutally breaking down the issues of the day.
From politics to pop culture, we take a look at all of it. So don't miss out.
Weeknights at 9.
For something new and unique in talk radio, take a listen to the Ben Shapiro Show.
On SuperTalk Mississippi.
Mississippi 811 is here for your safety. So we're asking you to call 2 working days before you do, or use our easy 811 app.
Whether you're a professional or a homeowner putting up a simple fence,
you can notify us and our member utility companies. We'll properly mark all their utilities.
This helps us save you from fines, penalties, injuries, or death.
Make our goal your goal with 0 damages and 0 injuries.
Call Mississippi 811 before you dig.
And let's have 0 damages, 0 injuries.
Whether you're a rebel, a bulldog, a golden eagle, or just a sports fan, SuperTalk Mississippi has got a podcast for you. For you. Sports Talk Mississippi, The Rebel Report, Thunder and Lightning, the Super Talk Eagle Hour are all now available for you. And it's all free. Free. Get them all on demand at supertalk.fm and on your smartphone. Just search for SuperTalk on iTunes, Google Play, or anywhere you listen to podcasts.
A phone call is made. A business keeps running. A class is still in session. Even in times of uncertainty, it's CSpire team members like you that make it happen. From curbside pickups and same-day deliveries to installing free Wi-Fi hotspots and ensuring our network is more reliable than ever, it's clear that you are truly customer-inspired. And thanks to your hard work, we all stay connected because you care.
Making your afternoon just a little brighter. It's Good Things with Rebecca Turner on Super Talk Mississippi.
It's my birthday.
It's my birthday.
Hey.
It's It's not my birthday, but in the studio, we've got Jill Gordon. She's the CEO and founder of Enrich Mississippi, and it is her birthday. But before we get to that, we want to remind you that the ice and the snow has melted or it's on its way to melt. And so that means you are going to want to plan yourself a Mississippi adventure, and you can do that by going to visitmississippi.org. And we are finding out a little bit more about Enrich and Enrich Mississippi's mission around, I guess, teen vaping, and specifically the leadership team that they have put together with students to sort of help move this movement through Mississippi. On the phone, we have Callie, who was sharing with us how she got into Enrich Mississippi and a personal story. So continue with us, Callie.
Yes, ma'am. So continued on that, I kind of started learning more, and then we got to the weeks coming up before the summit, and Miss Jill reached out to me to be one of, like, the more, like, taking control over the team a little more, like a step up, and I felt very honored, and she wanted me to kind of run our Instagram page. So in doing that, I had to look up more facts, reach out to people, and kind of come out of my comfort zone, because they don't know me personally, but sometimes that's not really my place, I guess. Like, I don't know, that's not where I usually do stuff. So it made me come out. It made me learn some more about this terrible thing. And so I started making graphics and stuff and growing in my learning. And then a teen girl at my school was found passed out on the floor because she had inhaled something that she had no clue what was inside. When she went to the hospital, it did come up that something had gone wrong. And on her scans, it showed that she could have possibly died from that. And so that opened my eyes even more and grew my caring for this so much more. So when the summit came up, I wanted to reach out to people and let them know that this is going on.
And you're talking about teen vaping going on. And we've got some more of your leadership chair members here, the two chairs here joining us in the Good Things studio. Again, if you go over to supertalk.fm/watch, you will see that I have now doubled the beautiful women that are is in the studio with me today here on Good Things. I have with us Hallie, who's also, Hallie got it right. All these hard names on a Monday is just, and DeAmber, who is also Miss Jackson teen. She is wearing her crown and all today. I am so impressed that you got up on this Monday and got so fabulous for us here on Good Things. I feel like we're all struggling just a little bit, but you look on point.
Yes,
and I'm so happy, too, to know that you guys are chairing this leadership team for Enrich Mississippi. So we'll start with you, DeAmber. How did you get involved with the leadership team?
Well, from a young age, I did really know about vaping and tobacco because my older sisters, they had been involved in the Rat Pack, and they went around schools teaching kids not to do tobacco. Then once e-cigarettes started getting more popular, they started talking about that too, and so I caught on to that, and part of my platform for my title as Miss Jackson's Outstanding Teen is called Understand Beforehand, and I knew that I needed to get involved in the community, and I got in touch with Miss Jill, and she let me be on the team with the Enrich Mississippi, and that's how I learned about it.
So what is your story, Hallie?
So my mom actually met Miss Jill at a medical convention, and they became good friends. They talked a lot about the topic, and my mom, being a high school parent, was concerned about vaping and the epidemic. So she talked to Jill, and then my mom talked to me, and we decided that I could get some great leadership roles and opportunities and spread the awareness about all of the dangers of vaping through this. And we have done so well. I'm so happy with everything we've gotten to do and that Jill's given me the opportunity to do.
So what are some of the shockers that you've learned by being part of this leadership program with Enrich Mississippi? I mean, obviously you girls are probably wouldn't have tried tobacco or e-cigarettes regardless of having Enrich come in. I mean, there's always just the two types of students.
Or would they have?
Or would they have? I don't know. But we're going to assume that they didn't, that they have good heads on their shoulders. But, you know, other kids are curious and just start to try things. That doesn't put them in any other, you know, sort of category. But what were some of the big takeaways? Like Cali was just sharing with us the fact that she didn't know all the stuff that was in there, and you find a student unresponsive. I mean, that's scary. So what are some of the shocker things about vaping that you've learned that you're sharing with your peers?
See, I'm Go ahead.
Well, with me, I had already been drilled in my head about how bad it was, and I hadn't really been seeing it. But as I got older and I realized that my friends were trying it too, I could see the side effects. I saw different things. And then being on Enrich, it allowed me to get good sources so I could learn good information on it. And once I found all that out, I really realized how actually terrible it is.
For you?
Okay, yeah. I learned so many things about what are in vapes that I didn't know before that really scared me, freaked me out. But I think the most shocking thing I've learned is part of Enrich. We have a member who's a sixth grader, and she was telling me about how sixth graders are doing this and talking about vaping. And when I was in sixth grade, I had no clue what that was. And it's just shocking that it's all the way down to lower, like, kids that...
Or do kids just not fear it? I mean, is it a thing of, do they just feel like it's safe if the parents don't know what they're talking about? Is it kind of like the same thing with smoking, or is there something else going on at the schools that parents need to know about? Nobody's going to share who you are.
See, kids aren't aware of the dangers because you've always been warned about the dangers of smoking, but you weren't raised on the dangers of vaping, and you should be. That's something that we need to talk about and that parents need to talk to their kids about and just be open with them so they can educate them before they're in a scenario where they're offered something and they want to try it because it's cool or because it looks fun or maybe because of the flavors that are fun. So it's just something that kids are getting introduced to a lot younger now.
DeAmber, you talked about your sister who was in the Rat Pack, which was Reject All Tobacco. I think that's one thing Mississippi did well from the get-go with the tobacco settlement there with the Partnership for Healthy Mississippi. And it feels like, man, we were really, you know, honing in that message. And then here comes, you know, another sort of curveball sort of with it. But what made that successful was once students started to realize the lies behind the marketing and the targeting of youth for tobacco, they really started to fight back on it. Are you feeling like that we're also seeing that with e-cigarettes, even though it feels like it's starting to sort of exacerbate on who all's, you know, using it? But are students waking up to the fact that this is just a bad idea?
I do feel like some students are waking up about it, but I think it should be enforced a little bit more. There should be more consequences and stuff in schools and in community areas, because we need the same way we're trying to enforce it, there needs to be a good consequence. If we're enforcing it and you can still get away with it, then that's defeating the purpose.
And Jill, I know that's a part of Enrich that you're proud of, too, is the policymaking part. I mean,
yes.
It's one thing for parents to say that you can't do it, but it's another thing for our schools and our administrations to sort of get behind it, too. What's happening on that front?
Excellent. I'm so glad that you brought that up. But I also wanted, before we get into the legislative piece, I also wanted to comment on something Hallie said. And I don't believe vapers identify themselves as smokers. And we talk a lot about that in several of the panels in the Vaping Summit. But as far as the legislative goes, we have several champions at the state capitol that have really fought really hard last year and this year. I went to the Capitol last week. Anybody that knows me knows I love going to the state capitol, and I'm so appreciative of all the lawmakers there to help Mississippi children, because to me there's nothing more important than our future. But we did a legislative panel discussion with Senator Nicole Boyd, Representative Nick Bain, Dr. Jim Risch out of Northeast Mississippi, Bubba Bland, which is a mayor, and then Rhonda with the partnership moderated that with a high school student. And that information really talks about what we're facing from an enforcement perspective. And then we've got some new legislation on the table that will make it harder as far as ID. That's one thing we talked about in the youth leadership panels, is it's extremely easy for kids to get. And we've got to tighten that up a little bit. And our Mississippi legislature is definitely working towards that.
And I know there's several schools in Mississippi, too, Jill, that have already put forth some implementation and policy and making it a little bit tougher. I know you're proud to be part of that, too, at least here in Central Mississippi. Share what they're doing.
Yes. So in part of the Vaping Summit, we did a panel discussion with Rankin County School District that outlaid everything they did to fight this. And any school can listen to that 30-minute panel discussion and get all the tools needed to do the same thing. They put together an ordinance that banned teen vaping. They put together consequences in their schools if children were caught with vapes, they worked on legislation, you know, helping communicate to lawmakers. They've done a lot of different things. They help pass our information along to parents, share our podcast and things like that.
Well, if we wanted to pass on here while we're winding down on good things, information to parents, Hallie, what would be your call to parents to action when it comes to vaping?
My number one thing when it comes to parents is talking to your kids at a young age about the dangers of vaping, what's in them, and all the consequences. If you have that conversation with your kid when they're young and they still end up doing it, that's when you have the right to be really upset about it because you've already had the conversation.
D'Ambra?
I completely agree with that. I'm kind of going to piggyback off of that with the parents being able to talk to them and really just holding a conversation and making sure that they know how bad it is, what all in it, what all is in the vapes, and what could happen to you once something bad has happened.
And Jill, where can we go for that playback of the summit?
EnrichMS.org. All the content is free. We have over 12 presentations for the entire community. There is something for everybody, whether they're a parent, grandparent, lawmaker, or school administration. There is everything you need to know about the teen vaping epidemic in Mississippi.
All righty. Will you stick with us? We've got more for you up next.
SuperTalk.fm has a new look and is more informative than ever with expanded Mississippi news coverage, the latest Mississippi weather, Mississippi sports, and of course, the talk that's important to you. Every show, every podcast, and every late-breaking story.